Good morning, everybody. We Paddy from Across the Shock. I'm saying good morning. It's good afternoon, actually. But nevertheless, look, this is just a wee chat video. I wasn't going to do one. And then I was sitting here and I was using this Worksharp. This is the new one, the £50 budget sharpening tool. It's only got 3 stones. But I have to say, this is about the, I don't know, 4th time I've used it or whatever. It's flipping brilliant. Honestly, it is so easy to just pull it. I leave it sitting up on my windowsill. If you've seen any of my videos, I just pull it down, start sharpening. I don't have to worry about water. I don't have to worry about setting. I set my angle, off I go. And I have to say, it is just, look, I was sharpening. The reason I started this video, this is my little LT Wright Frontier. From these knives sent me this. It's an absolute brilliant. He sent me another one, not a Frontier, it's something else, but it's down the caravan. This is the one that sits by my, I actually have it in a wee pouch down the side of my big chair, and I use this for opening boxes, doing anything at all, from cleaning my nails to opening boxes. It's just a smashing little fixed blade. It has a blade cutting edge of about 2 1/4. Absolutely brilliant. It really is. The stock isn't that thick, and you wouldn't expect it to be that thick if you can see it. You wouldn't expect it. But I just sharpened it on this at 20 degrees. I haven't stropped this. Genuinely haven't stropped it. I'm going to do another cutting of me doing one. I have a wee knife I'm going to show you now in a minute, and I'll do a video of a cutting. But this, for a little fixed blade, it's just, listen to that, there's no noise. They're just flying off it. Does it cut hair? Yes, it does. So it took about 15 minutes. I didn't rush, I just done it, and I didn't go overboard. I just done nice and gently, no pressure, and it brought it up a treat because it was nearly blunted. It had been lying on my wee thing, and I've used it and used it and used it. So absolutely great. I have to say, I can't recommend this highly enough. And if you're not a knife sharpener, you can use this. You can use it and get amazing results with no skill whatsoever. Hence, I've got it. But I genuinely love it. So, while I was out, I had some other knives out. You can see this jumble. There's a lot of them fixed blades. And I was just checking what I had up in the house, because I have the caravan and I keep an awful lot of stuff down the caravan as well. So I split my knives. And I picked up recently, and this year, more fixed blades than I've ever had. So I'm just going to run through some of them and how I'm getting on with them, how I'm using them. This is the Big Brother knife. I've got the smaller fixed blade of this down the caravan. This is the 4-inch blade. This is a 4-inch cutting blade. This is a beautiful. This is the, what is this one? The F005 in D2. Yeah, in D2. An absolutely cracking piece. Really is lovely. My Carta handles beautiful in the hand, huge grip on it. So if you've got bigger hands than mine, I'm medium large, there's plenty of room. Scandi grind, beautiful, beautiful knife. Highly recommend that. Again, AliExpress is the only place I know where you can get that, but a great, great option. Here's another one I got this year, and it was a bit of a laugh I got it for. It's a Rough Rider. I don't know whether you've seen, I have a video on all these, just go back and have a check on them. This is a Rough Rider. It's heavy, it's big brass, it's full tang, it's brass. This is like a, it's a shiny, well gnarled and grooved. They've actually put some lovely grooves. You would have to go back and see the video, see the close up of it. But look at that belly for a skinning knife. Is that not just, I don't do any skinning, but I just love this knife in hand. Full 4-finger grip, absolutely beautiful. It's just a 420 or 440A that Rough Rider do. But it is a gorgeous knife, really substantial and feels solid. Comes with a sheath. That Brother is about 40 quid or something. This was, I think, £17. I can't remember. It was about £70. I know it was cheap. But what a beautiful, you get the little leather case. Great little beater. And what else have I got? Here's one that I've done a video on a long time ago. This is a San Remo little fixed blade. Comes with a sheath and a wee belt lock there. You can put it on your belt and carry it. You can see I have mine orientated to carry on my belt. Oh, like that. Oh, can't really see it there. It just goes on my belt and I carry it side carry. Absolutely beautiful. There's little jimping here to help you. Just put your thumb there and push it out. Beautiful little knife. It's, I believe it's 8CR. I think it's 8CR. Not very thick, but so comfortable in hand. Just a nice wee, if you don't want to go to the expense of an LT Wright, which are more expensive, there's Sander Mui. I think this is about 20 quid or under it. But again, AliExpress is, or anywhere else that does Sander Mui. I think Gearbest does Sander Mui. Worth going and checking that one out. This is one I got this year, and I'm just now going to sharpen it. I suppose this is where this all, I went and got this. I knew I'd had it, but I hadn't seen it for a while. This is a wee CRKT, tiny little knife. Overall, what is it? Let me just see. Overall, it is about 5.5 inches with a cutting length of 2.5 inches. Lovely, thin little knife. Great little fixed blade. Not sure what price this was. This was a gift. So it's G10 on the handle, which is inside the outline of the blade. So it feels like you're getting a good grip. It's contoured. There's no hot spots in that wee thing. With a wee lanyard, I can get a really good, secure grip. Beautiful little knife. I don't even know what it's called. It's the F4D2 or O2KN. I can't even read that. Is it somebody design? I don't know. Can't read it, but I'll do a wee video on this, and I'm going to use that there to sharpen it, just to let you see how good it is. So I'll do that wee video this week. There you go. Lovely little knife for the pocket. Comes with its little, it's not Kydex, but it's plastic sheath, with a little pocket clip if you wanted to use the pocket clip. I just dropped this in my pocket. Although, keep that on it, because you never know. If I'm out and I'm using it, I'll just do it. If I'm going to be in and out of my pocket, I'll use the clip. But lovely little knife. Now, I was watching Cedric and Ada. I love Cedric and Ada, and he's bought a new house and he's been doing it up, and he used a tool that I've never used before. I love my Moras, right? Always love my Moras. I've got my one down the caravan. It's probably my most used fixed blade ever. Well, it is my most used fixed blade because I love it. This is a Halton Forge. Pete has just raved about this. He's just used it for opening metal oil barrels, everything. He was using it for everything around the house, for fitting doors, for putting hinges on. It is, look at that. It is a chisel knife. This is a full blade here and a chisel across the top. Now, it's not Scandi. It looks like it's Scandi if you're looking at it, but it's not. It's got a secondary bevel along, I think that might be Scandi. Yeah, I think that's Scandi, but it's a secondary bevel along this edge. And he raved about it. So I really recommend you go over and see Pete's channel. And I bought this because I'm going to be doing a bit of woodwork down the caravan this year. It's not even chisel grind. This top half is obviously... No, it's not. It's not chisel. I'm saying obviously. But it's not. It's not chisel grind. But he recommended this for doing woodwork. And I thought, right, well, I'll get one. I'll throw it in the box. I think it was £7.80 on Amazon. Just the handle on it, I can't explain to you. That's my four fingers. Look how much extra. That is an amazing tool. And I watched what Pete done with it, and I just couldn't believe it. So I've got that. I'll try that out, do a review on it, let you see what it's like using it on a bit of wood. Now, what else? This here, the only thing I wanted to check with this is when you put a knife in the little jaws of this, is how accurate it is up and down. Does it move? If you put it in a wee bit off, will it keep it there? So I bought myself one of these little boxes. This has got a magnetic bottom on it, but it's for setting your angles. And all I done was put my knife on, put that down, put this, the wee turn slide on it, to whatever angle I wanted, and then I set that there. I just set it on the top, held it on, and was able to get the measurement. Now, when I done that little knife, it was off by a couple of degrees from one side to the other. But it was literally, they were both on 20, but it was 20.0 something off on the, you know, they weren't exactly the same, but they were as good as I'll ever need it. But it was nice to be able to check it, that I was getting it right, that it was in the vise right, and it stayed there to the end, and it did. So perfectly great to put your knives in the vise, and it seems to be perfection. But having this really lets me check it, especially when I'm going to use my better knives and I want an exact bevel. And by exact, I mean as close as I can get. So that was really good. I think that was £8 from Amazon, delivered to my door. Amazing. Comes in its own wee pouch. Absolutely great tool. Absolutely great. What else have I bought? This is rubber. This is the rubber you get from all the knife outlets for taking rust off your blades or things like that. What it is also brilliant for is cleaning up your ceramic, your white ceramic stone. Instead of having to go out and get your grit and, well, I used to use like an Ajax, it's a powdered bleach, put it on it and scrub it all off. This doesn't clean it as nice, but it takes all the rubbish, the old filings out of it. Really great. And it also cleans the metal filings off the... There we go. You can see there's... I don't know why you can see. I haven't really got this set up for it. But I'll maybe do this when I'm doing the video. The metal filings, you just do that, literally, and that's all the metal filings cleaned off that. So, again, a simple little tool. I don't, they were about £4. I've had mine for a while. As you can see, it's well and truly rubbed. But a tool that's just, for that price, is indispensable. What else did I buy? I bought this. This is a peening hammer. It's brass. So you have a plain brass end, but they also have a plastic end. If you don't want to damage anything, if you're going to hit something, you're not that worried about what it's going to look like. But this plastic end, I bought this for, as you know, I buy these knives, the old-fashioned type of knives that are maybe not sitting through. These are softer derelin handles. And sometimes with age, the pins get a wee bit loose and they part. So I bought this to peen these because I was using just a big hammer and that's no good. Whereas with this sort of scale, I can just use the plastic handle and bash directly on it. Now I put it on top of a wee vise on a solid bit of material. I'm going to do this one. If you want, I'll do a video of me peening this one. Let me know down below. So I'll do the sharpening one for this wee CRKT, which I'd forgotten I had this. This will be in my pocket. It weighs next to it. It's, I would say an ounce maybe. It just weighs nothing. Great little fixed blade to put in your pocket, throw in your pocket. But if you want a video of me sharpening that, on that, I shall do that for you. It takes about 15 minutes. I'll do a full video. Peening just takes a couple of minutes and see whether we can get the knife to stay together a wee bit better. So there's a couple of videos. If you want them, let me know. That's it. Oh, and there's another video coming up on the Hultenfors, the chisel knife. Absolutely love this. Absolutely love it. There you go. I'm away. Thanks very much for listening to me. I just fancied a wee chat. Take care. All the best. Paddy's gone. Cup of tea time.